do this on an annual basis. This is our fifth annual Veterans Day celebration. It's becoming a part of tradition, but I assure you tonight you're in for a real treat. The fifth grade scholars are just going to put on a wonderful show along with some of their support staff, and they'll be introduced individually as we get there. So Ms. Wallace will take care of that. But if you happen to have a cell phone, if you turn them off now and turn off your pagers or put them on vibrate, we'd appreciate it. We wouldn't want to spoil these precious voices. And I've been very lucky. I heard them this morning, so I know how good they really are. Number two, if you have a little one, a little bitty one, if they happen to be singing out of sync with the seniors, you feel free to take them to the rear back there, get them in tune, and bring them back. This is a family affair, so just take them out, tune them up, bring them on back. Okay. Now, after tonight, we're having a reception below the sanctuary in the fellowship hall. Let me give you the easiest directions for getting there. Excuse me for pointing. You go out through the rear, go this direction, towards the big parking lot, walk down the sidewalk, and you'll see a double door down there called the Magnolia Room. It'll have two signal reeds on the door. Go in there, and that's where Heidi and her bunch of angels have set up a wonderful reception for you. So leave, go to your left, and go down. Give her a few minutes, because she's going to be here enjoying the performance. And she got one child singing tonight. So give her a chance to get down and get all the punch bowls going and fill in his cups. Out to your left and down, and you'll see it down there. When you leave, that's the easiest way to leave from the parking lot also at the end of the reception. And believe me, everybody's invited. Bring your children down, your family, everybody's with you. We appreciate it. We can do that when we're not there. Okay, tonight, if you're a veteran and you've not received the patriot like I'm wearing on my right lapel, if you please raise your hand, if you've not received one and you're a veteran, you're a little young there, son. That's Nadine back there. And Nadine Johnson put these together for us. She's done a wonderful job. And I'm going to introduce you up to you. Right over there. She'll be wearing one of these vests, like I have on my lapel. There's a couple over here. Thank you very much. Also, you know, put a program together like this, it takes some talent on these wonderful kids and Miss Swan. But it also takes a lot of moms and dads working in the background. And they do a lot of hard work to get together, just sizing and distributing all these vests to these young people. But we owe our thanks here to Leanne Abbott, who's done it for the second year, I know, and Pam Bradbury. Are they here tonight? Hopefully, a lot of you, I see them, have flags. That's a new addition this year. So at the conclusion of the service and the tribute to the veterans tonight, if you please drop your flag in the basket in the rear of the church, we'll use them again next year. So drop them off, and you'll have to buy them again. Thank you very much for that. Our videographer, who I don't see, there he is, David. That's David Swan up in the Balfry. And he'll be providing a video. We send that to a veterans hospital, but they also put several copies in the library of the school. So if you want to see it later, feel free to stop by and check out a copy and return it, just like the kids do their books. But we enjoy having it available for us. But Donald Swan will be making that video tonight. Okay, now, as always, we're very blessed in Shelton Falls to have a professional photographer parent. And Roxanne McIntosh, where I don't see her, but she's really running around taking pictures and flashing. She generally makes those available to the parents after they go on the bulletin board at the school. So be looking out if you visit over there. One is very methodical. She gives you a list of everything. And we always will recognize Heidi Danielle. She's done so much work putting together two receptions today. Heidi, would you stand up, please? And you come off and help her out. And the food is provided typically by the public from Shallowford as well as the Kroger of the school. So we always appreciate our partners in education to help us out. And I think if I left out something, I'll be punished for it. I think I've covered two of the three pages. But we really do appreciate all you people coming tonight. And veterans, this is for you. Whether you served in the air, on the seas, or on foreign soils, you did your job to protect our heritage. And our heritage is freedom. So you can worship, and you can speak, and you can live in a free society. And for that, we owe you the deep debt of gratitude. gratitude. Thanks again for coming tonight so we can recognize you. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Very well done, students. I am so proud of you. The concert's just begun. Good evening and welcome to our 5th Annual Veterans Day program. What greater privilege could these students have than to give honor to so many special guests we have with us today. At this time, we'd like to recognize all our special guests in the audience. Are there any World War II veterans with us tonight? We were so honored to have Mr. Veterans tonight. We're so glad that you are here, our World War II veterans. And what about veterans of the Korean War? Do we have any veterans of the Korean War with us tonight?
I suppose
those you have noted in your programs already, where songs indicated where we would like audience participation on the Songs America and the Armed Forces Medley, so we invite you to please sing with us. We have some special guest musicians tonight we'd like to recognize, and please join me in welcoming our accompanist, Tom Alderman. Mr. Alderman is the organist and music associate at Roswell United Methodist Church. Mr. Alderman? Mrs. Penny Palmer is a vocal soloist, and you may have heard her at Roswell Square or Marietta Square singing in the past, and she's with us tonight. And there she is. We have a trumpet soloist from Lassiter High School, Scott Curley, over here. And we also have a bagpipe player tonight. This is Marianne Bedford, and she's back there. We are so glad to have all the special musicians with us. At this time, we are very honored to have Staff Sergeant David Roof of the United States Marines to lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance. Staff Sergeant Roof has 15 years of service with the Marines and is currently the Ordnance Division Chief for the Marine Aviation Logistics Squadron 42 at Naval Air Station Atlanta. He is the father of two students at Shallowford Falls, fourth grader David and third grader Amanda. Please join me in welcoming Staff Sergeant David Roof.
I pledge allegiance
to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Oh.
Oh,
Lord,
have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Thank you. Boys and girls, you can be seated at this moment. You're doing a great job. We welcome Liz Aislinger from Mrs. Dreher's fifth grade class. And she will recite a poem for us titled The Flag of the Brave.
The beautiful flag that's before my eyes washes away back, this truth, not lies. The sight takes my breath away. I'm transported back to the sweet spring day. When the sun shines on the prairie, sadness is changed to joy, I feel merry. When the moonlight hits the snow-capped peak, honor to those who brought me this flag is what I seek. They deserve glory, that's why I cry. When the unhonored heroes fall and die, I'm thankful that my flag still will yet wave. Because of bravery, America is saved. Let no shadow cast over us, not till courage's last day. That will only be when all heroes pass away. The veterans stand tall, not disrespected at all. America the mighty and bold, our tower, our refuge, our stronghold. Behold the flag of the brave, those heroes their lives have laid to have our death delayed. The flag of the mighty, past soldiers who fought in war, their hearts are courageous down to the core. God bless the USA, bless the standing veterans today.
Writing such beautiful words. Thank you, Liz. That was very inspiring and very beautiful.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America.
would bring that song back in the program every year. It is such a crowd pleaser, and I must admit to you, when I was introducing Liz Aislinger, I had a moment of panic there because there were so many requests for her poem to be copied and people wanting a copy of it, that I pulled it out of my program book, ran to the copier at school and copied bookfuls of copies so she could give out to people requested. And then as I turned to my program book, I feared that I forgot to put it back in my program book, and I was afraid, I'm going to hear it, but it all turned out good.
Director of Education of the Air Education and Training Command. While serving in these roles, he was responsible for the personal and professional development of cadets in the U.S. Air Force Academy, the Air Force Academy, and was responsible for the professional military education, continuing education, and graduate education of both officers and enlisted personnel. As an officer of the Air Force, he distinguished himself as a leader, a pilot, a trainer, a commander, garnering over a dozen major awards and decorations, and serving on 607 combat missions during the Vietnam War. While Commandant of the Air Force Academy, he was responsible for the administration of the cadet system and honor code. Superintendent Redden is a native of Council Bluffs, Iowa, and a graduate of the U.S. Air Force Academy. He has earned a master's degree in political science from Auburn University. Superintendent Redden and his wife, Shirley, please stand, Shirley. We're so glad to have you tonight. Superintendent Redden and his wife, Shirley Redden, have two grown children, so with great honor, we want to welcome our Superintendent of Schools, Joseph Redden.
Make ours a better community and make ours a better country. And you should never forget that there is no act that you would commit, no act of charity or kindness that is too small, and that you yourselves can make tremendous differences with all the good things you do in your lives. So we thank you again for this wonderful tribute to our veterans. And we know that anyone who will come and have an opportunity to see it tonight will be honored, as we all are, by your wonderful performance. And we wish you the best of good fortune for the rest of the school year, and we hope that you find God's blessings every day in your life. And with that, we would like to now welcome our piper, Master Sergeant Marianne Medford, 96 Air Force retired, who is going to play her pipes in honor of our fallen heroes and those who died on 9/11. And after Sergeant Medford plays her pipes, you will have the song for an unsung hero by our chorus. Thank you very much.
God with us tonight. Not only the children, but these wonderful soloists, Ms. Bonner and Scott Curley. Let's give them a round of applause. We'll continue on now with Road to Freedom and Road to Freedom's Chamber Chorus. Would you please come on down?
Only one to be free. We had a love.
fabulous job, boys and girls. We are honored to have Lieutenant Earl, We are honored to have Lieutenant Colonel Earl Opie of the United States Army retired to introduce our tribute to Bob Hope. Mr. Opie served 20 years of active duty in the Army, including a one-year tour of Vietnam. His branch was the Medical Service Corps. Mr. Opie, we are so honored to have you back again this year and have your presence with us this evening to introduce our tribute to Bob Hope.
Sound person Kevin Hoover and another tech person from
Johnson Ferry Baptist John, who's in the back, with fifth grade teacher Charlotte Dreer. Thank you very much for the wonderful presentation. Also grateful to my husband, who was not able to be here tonight. He's still in Toronto on a business trip, but he put together this wonderful video and PowerPoint images that you're seeing tonight. We are very honored to have with us Lieutenant, excuse me, I seem to be making all kinds of mistakes this evening on my ranks and titles. I'm going to start that over. We are honored to have Corporal Mike Nolan of the Cobb County Police Department with us to introduce the Armed Forces Medley. Corporal Nolan is a veteran of the United States Army, having served in the Vietnam War as a helicopter pilot for 7 years. He comes from a family of men who have devoted their lives to serving in the Army. Before joining the Cobb County Police Department, Corporal Nolan served on the Atlanta SWAT team. In all, he has 30 plus years of service in the Atlanta Police Force. 2 years ago, last May, Corporal Nolan nearly lost his life in a motorcycle accident while on duty. As he was traveling down the interstate, the engine of his motorcycle came loose and caused him to have a near-fatal wreck. He spent 9 months in recuperation from multiple fractures, plastic surgery, and head injury. Corporal Nolan currently serves in the Education Department as a public speaker on topics of motivation and inspiration. Before he introduces the Armed Forces Medley, I've asked him to share a most amazing and incredible experience he had while serving in the Army as a helicopter pilot. We are so glad you're back with us again, Corporal Nolan.
Necessarily always picked up Army personnel. We also picked up Air Force pilots. pilots that had the misfortune to get shot down, and the Marine Navy pilots, and even some of their grunts, we call them grunts. One day, I was flying what we called I can't remember what we called it. That's another thing that happens when you hit on your head at 70 miles an hour. I blame that, and I'm 57 years old, for my senior moments, but I can't remember what we used to call that initially. Anyway, we weren't supposed to be shot at, we were just out flying around having a good time. And we heard some Marines calling for help. Now, you know, bear in mind, we were Army, they were Marines, but in combat, you don't care, right? We joke about each other and stuff in peacetime, but we're all a band of brothers. So we hear them calling for help. It was a Marine recon unit, it was five men, and they were running for their lives. And they were being chased by a considerably larger unit of North Vietnamese soldiers in a place called the Ashaw Valley. And they were calling for help, and no one would go in because the shooting was so bad. Now, me and my crew, there was only four of us on the Huey helicopter that I was flying, but we talked it over. We weren't heroes. We just couldn't stand the thought that there were some guys down there that if somebody didn't go in, we're going to die. I get emotional, so excuse me. So we all agreed, and we went in. I called them on our FM radio, and I said, you know, we knew where they were, and I told them we're going to come in and get you. We actually landed on a jungle trail. Well, what really makes this stunning or story unique is my partner, Bruce Bassett, that I work with, always in public speaking now. He's a lot older than me. He asked if anything funny ever happened in Vietnam when I was flying. This is what I thought of. Well, you know, you think bullets going through your helicopter isn't very funny, but when we sit down on the trail, I look, and here comes these five Marines, and I mean, they're really running. And unless you've been shot at trying to run, you really don't know why they're running so fast. I mean, it's amazing what you can do when you're scared. But here they come, and we had taken our doors off of our helicopter, the cargo doors, which we just really didn't need them in Vietnam. So I'm sitting there and I'm watching, and I smoked a great big corn cob pipe, and the more smoke that came out of my cockpit, the more excited I was. We always looked like we were on fire. But I'm looking, and I'm sitting there just shaking and waving, and here they come. The first Marine to us takes a dive. And when he did, he hits inside the cargo compartment and goes right out the other side. Get on okay. He jumps back on and I'm looking at him and I'm laughing hysterically. Yeah, you know, he's beating me on the back of my helmet hollering, go, 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 go. So we go. Well, that was the last time I ever saw him. I always wondered, well, did he get killed or not? Did he survive? I tell my partner this on a Monday morning. This was last year. And then Tuesday we go to the Galleria to participate in a function over there, and he introduces me to a guy that he's been friends with for years and years. His name is Dwayne Hayes. He's the director of security over at the Galleria. He tells Dwayne, so Mike was a helicopter pilot in Vietnam for the Army. And then he starts talking to some other people, and Dwayne says, oh, you were? Well, I was a Marine recon leader. And he starts, so let me tell you something happened. Guess who Dwayne was? Years after that day, we became the best of friends. And I was hoping he'd be here tonight. If you have him back next year, he promised that he would come. So I hope that maybe y'all will come back and you'll be able to hear him tell his side of it. But I'm blessed to know him. I'm blessed to be a veteran. I'm blessed to be here tonight. And especially with the commander of the United States Air Force Academy. I mean, I'm honored. It's patriotism. Patriotism is back in America. Isn't it great? I could pass a flight visit and now save lives. Okay. Throughout our nation's history, our troops have answered the call to defend freedom wherever it has been threatened. These brave Americans are the national treasures we call veterans. As the students sing the Armed Forces Medley, we invite our active and veteran personnel, as well as families who have lost loved ones while defending our country, to stand and come forward when your service hymn is being sung. If you have a loved one currently serving and therefore not able to be with us, we ask that you represent your loved one by coming forward on his or her service hymn. Please remain through the conclusion of the Armed Forces Medley. Following the Armed Forces Medley, we would like the firefighters, police officers, and rescue workers in our audience to come forward and join the veterans as we all sing our closing song, God Bless America. Our wish is that when you leave this place, you will remember all those who are at work to restore peace. The soldiers who are fighting to keep us safe, as well as working to give the choice of freedom to those who have never known it. And let me say one other thing. Thank God we still got young people that will stand up for America.
Is with us tonight. She has a son who recently entered the Marines. First, second grade teacher, Ms. Bixby, are you here tonight? We certainly would welcome her up. I don't know if she was able to come, but she was at the morning performance. Ms. Drew back there has a son in the Marines, and if she was able, she would come up here to represent her, but she's working back there for us. So thank you again, Ms. Drew. Okay, I want to give you a heads up, you Army veterans, that first up on the Armed Forces Medley is the Caisson song. So I would ask you to join and come up here on your service hymn. And if you've been here before, then you know that we want you to come up here and fill up this area so we can honor you. And I might also mention, if you don't mind, that I have a son in the Air Force. He's a firefighter, and I'm very proud of him. So we will start our Armed Forces Medley right now.
Thank you. Thank you.
very much. That is just wonderful. And boys and girls, I'm going to ask you to sit for just a moment. We have a couple of thank yous still left. Wow, that was the most incredible sight to see so many honored guests up here. My heart is touched, as I know yours is. Boys and girls, I want to thank you for a fabulous performance. It was just so wonderful. So grateful to that wonderful team of fifth grade teachers and the specialists. And would you please come up, teachers, for the fifth grade team is Lori Brannaman, Kenny Clark,
to now honor you, Mrs. Swan. Several fifth grade families have offered to serve a chili dinner with all the fixings to the firehouse of your choice. We offer you our most sincere and heartfelt thanks on behalf of all of the fifth grade families here at Shalika Falls, thank you for teaching and for loving our children in a way that is exceptionally rare today. We appreciate you and we love you. Speechless. Thank you so very much, boys and girls, and to honor me with these beautiful flowers and dinner for the fire stations. That is so very touching to me. My dad was a firefighter, and my little son's a firefighter in the Air Force, so that's definitely a very tender spot in my heart for firefighters, and these are the most beautiful flowers, and I just heard somebody whisper, "Are those real?" Thank you very much, boys and girls. Thank you so very much. Okay, I'm going to let Ms. Partez direct the exit here because the teachers have been so great about organizing that for me.